Today we are going to address or discuss new topic, which is workforce diversity and generationalism. After studying this topic, you should know 3 points. Number one, the meaning of diversity and different generations at work. Number two, stereotypes as a barrier to valuing diversity. Number three, what should organizations and HR management do to manage a diverse workforce? What is the meaning of diversity? Diversity refers to the difference among people based on nationality, religion, physical or mental disabilities, or ethnicity. Today, organizations want a group of heterogeneous employees working together with different minds instead of a homogeneous group consisting of the same type of people. The first point, we want to know the meaning of diversity. Diversity means that the difference among people based on some factors, based on nationality, based on ethnicity, based on religion, based on age, based on gender, and physical or mental disability. تنوع يقصد بالاختلافات بين البشر based on على أساس الجنسية بتاعتهم، على أساس الدين بتاعهم، العمر، الديانة and so on. Now organizations want a group of heterogeneous employees working together with different minds instead of a homogeneous group consisting of the same type of people. Organization now عايزة مجموعة من العاملين اللي هم المختلفين اللي يشتغلوا مع بعض وعندهم اختلاف في العقول بتاعتهم، اختلاف في الأفكار، اختلاف في الفاليوز. ما عادتش عايزة مجموعة من الأشخاص تعمل معا وهي عندها نفس الفاليوز، عندها نفس الاتيتيودز، عندها نفس البرسبكتيفز. In this slide, we will see 3 types of generations. We can see them in all our organizations. The first generation is called baby boomers. This generation was born from 1947 to 1966. The second generation is called Generation X. This generation was born from 1967 to 1979. The third generation is called the Millennials. This generation was born from 1980 to 1995. Every generation comes to the organization with his new attitude, perspectives, values, which have shaped by the events which they experienced in their lives. This slide talks about the generation millennials. This generation has been exposed in their formative years to a variety of changes, economical changes, cultural changes, technological changes. These changes have shaped their attitudes and their values. This new generation was born in the age of information technology, عصر التكنولوجيا, the rise of computers, the internet, the smartphone, and the social media. Recent research, الدراسات الحالية في الـ HR found that new generations not only embrace technology مش بس بيحترم التكنولوجي but also view it بيروها as one of the characteristics أحد الصفات that differentiate them اللي بتفرق عن بتفرقهم from all previous generations عن كل الجنريشن السابقة. What is the difference between baby boomers and generation X and generation Y? Baby boomers focus on a team. يحبوا يشتغلوا مع جروب من الناس. Generation X, لا, generation X focus on their career. بيركزوا على الكارير بتاعهم. Generation Y is completely different. Generation Y focus on their development. They want to grow. عايزين يكبروا. They want to learn. They want to be autonomous and independent. عايزين يكونوا مستقلين. They want rapid success. نجاح سريع. And make balance between their private life and their work. They want to be everywhere. في كل مكان at the same time. They want to respect their managers. عايزين يحترموا المانجرز بتاعهم. Because their managers are efficient and approachable. إن هم كفء وقريبين منهم. Not because they are their managers. Just only their managers. Another difference between the three generations, which is related to security. Security for baby boomers means that they must have a job and a pension plan. اللي بالنسبة لهم مهم جدا الأمان في يبقى عندهم وظيفة مستقرة وعندهم معاش. For generation X, generation X came into a saturated market. So they had to fight. كان عليهم انهم يحاربوا for their job. Security for them means having a strong CV. Regarding Generation Y, Generation Y, they don't have the same outlook. ما عندهمش نفس النظرة. Why? Because their parents are there for them. This slide talks about the conflict between generations. Baby boomers believe that millennials are not hardworking. They don't like to work long hours and don't dress professionally. And at the same time, they value flexibility and fun. بينما, while millennials believe that in Generation X and the baby boomers are more concerned about the hours they work than what they actually produce or accomplish. يعني in the millennials believe that in generations X والبيبي boomers بيهتموا أكتر أو focus more about work hours more than what they actually produce or accomplish. Generation X, for generation X, they have to fight and waiting for baby boomers to get out. As a result of these differences and the conflict between the generations, the organizations today find themselves in front of a big challenge. How to find a way for its employees to realize the importance of diversity, إن هم يدركوا أهمية الدايفيرسيتي and understand the meaning of generationalism in the workforce. We finished the first point, which is related to the three generations, the differences between them and the diversity at workplace. Now we are going to discuss the second point, which is stereotypes as a barrier to valuing diversity. What is the meaning of stereotypes? Stereotypes هي النماذج النمطية اللي بتعوق إعطاء قيمة كبيرة للدايفيرستي في مجال العمل. Again, what is the meaning of stereotypes? Stereotypes means that the tendency to classify people in a certain social category and ignore all the differences, all the variations among them. We tend to classify people based on gender, age, religion, nationality. These stereotypes have negative effect, great negative effect on how persons are treated in organization and thus affect their behavior and their performance. Now we are going to talk about some examples of stereotypes at workplace. The first example is stereotypes based on gender, بناء على النوع. All research, كل الأبحاث, has proved that women suffer from stereotype that has negative effect on their hiring, development, promotion, and salary. كل الأبحاث أثبتت إن المرأة بتعاني من النماذج النمطية للنظرة ليها سواء في تعيينها، في تطويرها، في ترقيتها، and في السالري المدفوع لها. Also, we always look at the man as a leader, and we don't have the same outlook to the woman. Women are not represented in top management like men. Also, أيضا, women are discriminated against when they are requested to attend a professional development conference. المرأة محرومة من هي تكون ليها مكانة في الإدارة العليا زي الرجل. وأيضا لما بيكون في مؤتمر، المؤتمر ده بيقدم فيه برنامج تدريبي عالي المستوى أو في تطور كبير، ده كله بيروح للرجل مش للمرأة. Also, women are chosen only for women jobs. زي إيه؟ Such as secretary and supervise other women. في دراسة حديثة one recently studied found that when women are successful in traditional male jobs, لما بتنجح في الوظائف بتاعت الرجل, they are less liked and that affect their evaluation and their recommendation for rewards. In spite of all these stereotypes which we talked about, today men no longer لم يعدوا dominate the workforce, بيسيطروا على قوة العمل. Recently or now, women and minorities والأقليات will represent the lion's share of labor force growth over the near future. هم اللي هيقودوا قوة العمل في المستقبل. And therefore, وعلشان كده, employers and organizations are striving for demographic balance, not just because the law says that, مش عشان بس القانون بيقول كده, but due to the self-interest, عشان مصالح. The second example for stereotypes is stereotypes based on age. What is the meaning of stereotypes based on age? It means that older workers are seen as having less capacity for performance, less productive, less creative than younger workers. بينظر ليهم على ان هم اقل في القدره، اقل في الانتاجيه، اقل في الابتكار عن الصغيرين. They are seen as having less potential for development، وان هم more rigid and less adaptable to new organization culture. بيتم النظر ليهم على ان هم اقل كفاءه واقل قدره على التطوير، وان هم اكثر صلابة أو تحفظ وليس أدبت وأقل القدرة على التكيف مع الثقافة بتاعة المنشأة. As a result of all these stereotypes in organizations, an older man was less likely to be hired for a finance job that required high-risk decisions. Also less likely to be promoted for a marketing position that required creative solutions to difficult problems. Aidan, less likely to be permitted to attend a conference on advanced production systems. However, the most comprehensive study on age and performance found that all these stereotypes, كل النماذج النمطية دي, are inaccurate, غير دقيقة, and we cannot generalize them, ولا يمكن تعميمها. For example, they found that older workers were found to exhibit, إن هم وجدوا إن الناس الكبار في السن, إن هم more citizenship behavior, بيقدموا سلوك مواطنة تنظيمية أكثر, وإنهم أقل في السلوك المضاد للإنتاجية, fewer counterproductive work behavior, and less workplace aggression, وأقل عدائية في مجال العمل, and also less tardiness, أقل تأخيرا, and less absentees, وأقل غيابا. Now we finish the first point, which is the meaning of diversity and the differences among generations. Also, we finished the second point, which is stereotypes as a barrier to valuing diversity. Now we are going to talk about how should organizations and HR management do to manage a diverse workforce. What should organizations and HR management do to manage workforce diversity? Number one, diversity and recruiting. HR management must choose candidates from different generations. تختارهم من كل الأجيال, from different genders, from different races, from different religions. Must give them positions, تديهم الوظائف that fit to their competencies, اللي هي متناسبة مع كفاءتهم, regardless of, بصرف النظر عن their age or gender or socioeconomic class, بصرف النظر عن كل ذلك. This is the first point. Number two, diversity and training program. Training programs are one of the most effective ways for organizations to manage diversity. Why? Because training programs can help in raising the awareness of the meaning of diversity and why diversity is very important for the organizations. Also, training programs can be designed to provide people, ممكن هو يصمم علشان يزود الناس with skills, بالمهارات, which are related to how work effectively in a diverse workforce. إزاي يشتغلوا بنجاح في مجموعة التنوع هذه. This is the second point. The third point, leadership development programs. Also, HR management can develop leaders and supervisors to be a role model for the behavior that required for a change. أيضا ممكن الموارد البشرية تلعب دور في تدريب المانجرز والسوبرفايزرز لكي يكونوا قدوة للسلوك المراد تغييره. The fourth point, performance evaluation. Organizations and HR management can change, ممكن يغيروا, the performance appraisal, تقييم الأداء, to evaluate supervisors based on their success, بناء على يقيموا أدائهم, بناء على نجاحهم, in reducing group conflict, في خفض الصراع بين الأفراد. Also, can reward managers and employees for their achievement, يكافئوهم على إنجازاتهم, which are related to to diversity issues in murtabita biqadaya al-tanawwu'. This is the fourth point. Number three, performance evaluation. Also, organizations and HR management can change the performance appraisal, تقييم الأداء, to evaluate supervisors based on their success in reducing group conflict. يعني يحطوها دي نقطة في موجودة أو فاكتور أو عامل من عوامل تقييم أداء المشرفين. Also, can reward managers and employees for their achievement لإنجازاتهم which related to diverse issues. Number five, retention. Also, HR management can maintain diverse workforce, ممكن تحافظ على قوة عمل متنوعة through work-life programs and intensives, من خلال برامج تحقق التوازن بين الحياة الخاصة وبين العمل وبين مجموعة أيضا إعطاء مجموعة من المحفزات such as زي إيه؟ زي on-site child care and also flexible work schedule, جدول عمل مرن. في النهاية in the end all types of generations, elders and youngers, women and men, minorities, كل التنوع دي, organizations must give them equal opportunities, فرص متساورة for hiring, training, promotion and holding the key jobs.